knows. I mean, he was secretary SERB for, he knows about science funding. The thing is how to give funding to the worthy person, number one. Number two, how to maintain accountability in this funding. So if the guy is not doing his work properly, we don't have a mechanism in India to stop that funding to that person. We tend to usually give funds to somebody because he is considered to be a great man. So these great men go on getting more and more and more money, and then it sort of becomes like a law of diminishing returns. That is the second challenge. The third thing is, I'll speak honestly. You know, Dr. Crickle here, I don't know, he looks pretty young. And yet he's done something that allowed somebody else from some faraway country to want to invite him to come here. We do not want to take a risk and a chance on young people. We say that unless some fellow is some old and thing like me, then only then old people are wise. No, old people are not necessarily wise. Some old people may be wise, we don't know. But the thing is that there are many young people who are very clever. And the other thing, one of my colleagues in the institute in Bangalore told me that science is very iconoclastic. Science is not democratic at all, because you can have some series of 10 wise people and one youngster can come and say something which is scientifically correct. Then all of them will be proved wrong. You know, science is not a government office. You know, fine, going up, coming down, signing, senior, junior. Anybody is senior, anybody is junior in science. So this is to identify this as a reality. I think in Indian science, the main problem is a mental problem. It's not money problem. Dr. Braspati will tell you there is enough money and more money in India to fund. It's not, oh, Malikum, Malikum, double edu, andike ikkada cheyagalamu, cheyalemu. చేయలేకుండా అయ్యో ఇంకా కొంచెం డబ్బు ఇస్తే ఇంకా కొంచెం చేయవచ్చు. ఇదంతా తప్పు, శుద్ధ వెర్రి అబద్ధం.